Good morning students, welcome to biology online class. In last session we have started the topic is the living organisms characteristics and habitats. We are already discussed different types of habitats like terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. Even terrestrial habitat also different types, there is grassland, forest, mountain, coastal and desert. Even aquatic habitat also, marine habitat and freshwater habitat. We are discussing the topic. Do all organisms get food? Means organisms and their characteristics also we are discussing. Do all organisms are take food? Yes, all organisms are take food. This food is giving energy to their body and doing different types of activities. Then all organisms are show growth? Yes. All organisms are show growth. Animals are growing certain period of the time, but plants are growing lifelong. Then all organisms are respite? Yes, animals are respite. They are taking oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide. Even plants also taking oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide by the process of respiration. But in photosynthesis, plant leaves having tiny spores are known as stomata. With their help of stomata taking carbon dioxide, in the presence of sunlight they are preparing food material and releasing oxygen. This process is known as photosynthesis. Already we have discussed by this process also. Okay, next. All organisms are respond to stimuli? Yes, all organisms, all living things are respond to stimuli. Then changes in our surroundings that make us respond to surroundings, that respond to the organism is known as stimulus. Stimulus is many examples are there. If you touch it, the touching on plant is a stimulus. Immediately the leaves are cooling is known as response. Not only touching on plant, in some types of daily activities, in daily activities many examples are there in that stimulus and response. When we are touching hot object is stimulus. Immediately rub at the hand is known as response. Okay, this also we have discussed in the last topic, last class. Next, living organisms and excrete. Yes, the process of getting rid of wastes by organism, the process of getting rid of wastes by organism is known as excretion. Excretion is an essential process, even plants and animals. Plants and animals. Then plants also, their wastes are secretion. Wastes are secreting through their plant stems. For example, rubber plant is secreting latex through their stem. Next, neem plant is secreting gums. Then different plants are their wastes are secreting in different ways. Okay, next, some plants are wastes are stored in different parts of the plant. Different parts of the plant. Let us now we discuss about the topic is do all organisms reproduce their own kind? Yes, all organisms are reproduce their own kind, but mode of reproduction is different in plants and animals. All organisms means all living things are reproduce their own kind, but mode of reproduction is different plants and animals also. Okay, see, if you take a small seed, bean seed, the seed is present in the shop many days, present in the shop many days. Once we have to bring the seed and plant in the soil, plant in the soil, and it is develop into young plant. It germinate and develop into young plant. Okay, once the seed is planted in the soil, it is utilizing their water, minerals and favorable conditions. The seed is germinate into a new plant. See, a seed from a plant germinates into a new plant. Germinates into a new plant. For example, bean plant. It is a bean plant. Okay, this plant, the seed is planted in the soil. The seed is planted in the soil. Within 1 week, at 7 days, it germinates a new plant under favorable conditions. For example, we are planting bean seed to develop into bean plant. Then we are planting mango seed to develop into mango plant. Means all organisms reproduce their own kind. Okay, next. Animals. Animals also reproduce their own kind. But the mode of reproduction is different. The mode of reproduction is different in animals. For example, there is a microorganisms are different in their reproduction. That is asexual reproduction. There is a spore formation, fragmentation and budding. Okay, these are the different types of reproduction is present in the animals. Next, some animals. Animals like birds. Birds are reproduce their eggs. Birds are lay eggs. Birds are lay eggs in their nest. In some days of the it is hatching and young ones are comes out of them. The young ones are comes out of them. Birds are reproduce less eggs. Birds are reproduce less eggs. Then animals. Animals are reproduce, give birth to young ones. Okay, animals are reproduce, give birth to young ones. So even plants, the mode of reproduction is different. Even animals like birds and animals, reproduction also different. There is a different mode of reproduction. Even animals also is present different types of reproduction. There is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Then plants also is present asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Okay, even plants and animals mode of reproduction is different. Then plants are for example bean plant. A seed from a plant generate a new plant. Many days the seeds are present in the shock. It is not showing any growth. Once you bring the seeds and planting in the soil, some days after under favorable conditions, each seed is generating a new plant. Okay, even beans, peas, soybean, etc. Okay, these seeds are generating into new plant under favorable conditions. Some plants reproduce in different parts, different ways. For example, cutting, layering and grafting. And some plants reproduce their vegetative parts like roots, stems and leaves. For example, potato. Potato. plant. The potato have a small eyes. These are called bud. This bud are separated from the part of the potato and plant in the soil. Plant in the soil and it develop into young plant. It develop into young plant. Means the potato is reproduced through the stem. The potato reproduced through the stem. Then carrot. Carrot is reproduced through roots. Carrot reproduced through roots. Even beetroot, radish also reproduced through the roots. Next. Not only potato, even sugarcane, ginger, turmeric. These plants are reproduced through the stems. It is about do all organisms reproduce their own kind? Yes, all organisms are reproduced their own kind. But the mode of reproduction is different in plants and animals. Plants, like bean plant, is germinate into new plant. Bean seed is germinate into new plant under favorable conditions. For example, bean seeds, peas and soya bean seeds are present more days in the shop. But once we have to bring the seed and plant in the soil under favorable conditions like air, water, sunlight, soil, under favorable conditions, each seed is generated in a new plant or in plant. Next, potato. Potato is reproduced through the stem. Potato reproduced through the stem. Then, not only potato, even turmeric, ginger and sugarcane also reproduced through the stem. Then, carrot. Carrot is reproduced their roots. Carrot is reproduced their roots. Even carrot, beetroot, radish. These plants reproduce their roots. Then some plants reproduce through the leaves. Some plants reproduce through the leaves. Bryophyllum is reproduced through the leaves. Bryophyllum is a broad leaf. The margins of the leaf is producing a small bird-like structures. Okay, each bird is drop fallen down and it develop into new plant. It develop into new plant. It is about the different mode of reproduction in plants. Even animals like birds. Birds are reproduced lays eggs. Birds are lays eggs in the nest. In some days after, the eggs are hatching and the young ones are comes out of the nest. Animals are reproduced, give birth to young ones. Give birth to young ones. Directly they are giving birth to young ones. Example, then cat, rat, dog, even human beings also. Human beings itself. Then birds. Birds like a parrot, squirrel, sparrow, pigeon, woodpecker. This type of birds are reproduced through eggs. Okay. This is about do all organisms reproduce their own kind. Thank you. Next class we will discuss about